This is Bloodstained, Ritual of the Night, E3 version. This was given to backers and I imagine members of the press. If you don't know what this is, I mean, it's not hard to guess, is it? But it's a spiritual, that's in air quotations, successor to Castlevania Symphony of the Night. I'll just play it. Let's be honest. You know what this is. Everyone knows what this is. After Mighty No. 9 recently came out, and people were horrified at basically everything about it, I think this came as somewhat of a relief to most people, because it's not a stinky pile of dog shit. It is, in fact, what you'd expect from a sort of Unreal 4 take on a 2D Symphony of the Night clone. Yeah, it's pretty bare bones, but again, it's... I think this is more to put the backers at ease than anything else. So that, you know, mechanics, a lot of the mechanics are in place, I imagine, pretty much within reason, for the early part of the game, all the mechanics are in place. Some set pieces, there's a boss battle, what more do you need? If you see any performance issues, which you likely are, it's because either this game's horribly optimised, or more than likely, it's having some sort of issue with OBS, which is super frustrating, but there you go. Ah, I just remembered, last time I played this, I forgot to equip the longsword! I ran around for ages with no sword, like an idiot. You can actually use the kicks to play the game, I believe, and get some kind of upgrades, probably boots, help you kick harder or faster or whatever it is. So that's completely reasonable. But yeah, it's Castlevania. That's the back step. Apparently that's all I know about Castlevania. Got the back step, it's Castlevania. If it were the two step, it'd be another game franchise. Right. Let's get out of here. I will play this to completion because it's not very long. And it is pretty cool. Controls don't feel as tight as... Tight as I remember Symphony of the Night feeling. Although, to be fair, Symphony of the Night always had an odd sort of feel to its controls anyway. I can never understand if that's a flaw or something I'm just misinterpreting. And I should have read that, because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. There you go. What? Oh no. Oh god. Wait, do I need a cannonball that I don't have? Gone. Shit. Let's assume I do. Anyway, you have magic abilities. That's pretty cool. It's mapped to the analog, so you can go in all directions. The right analog. Let's have a little look around here, because I've probably fucked that up. I quite like how the magic works. It's pretty cool. He's just going to float around harmlessly. I'll kill him. Oh god, no! So much harmless. Oh, you bastard. Wow. Well, show me. Been on a bit of sort of 2D gaming kick lately, as you'll likely see if you've watched some recent videos. Yeah, I'm determined to get good at these fucking things. And by good, just good enough to beat them. So, not gonna be speed running with a blindfold or any of that nonsense. I really can't remember if I missed the cannonball, it's quite frustrating. I've spent a lot of time lately playing bits and pieces of the traditional Castlevania games, if you want to call them that, before they started aping the Metroid series, and then for some reason retroactively stole the name. That's always bothered me. There is no Metroidvania, there's Metroid games. Castlevania, 10 years into its life cycle, whatever it was, decided to copy that formula to great success, as it would turn out. But they copied it no less. So bizarre that they sort of made a portmanteau out of the two names there. I don't know. It seems unreasonable to credit something. Because Ori in the Blind Forest was really good. Should they now be called Ori Castlevania Roids? Or Ori Castle Roid? Castle Roid Ori? Like, where does that trend end? You just keep adding games? I don't know. More of a Metroid fan than a Castlevania. Well, more of a Metroid fan than a Symphony of the Night fan, at least. I do like Castlevania. I admire the design of Symphony of the Night. The fact that you get to play through the whole goddamn castle upside down. That's just insane. To think that they made it with that in mind is just nuts. Especially in the day and age when it came out, at which point 2D games were sort of very passé. So, that was really cool. But Super Metroid's where it's at, let's be honest. It's the better game. It's the original game. And it controls better. Yeah, that's right. It would be nice if Metroid, in fact, at this point, turned around and copied some Castlevania traits, like having the XP, that'd be good. Again, I apologise for the performance. This is going really badly now. I don't know why. Annoying, so I've got a decent PC with a GTX 980 in there. And yet when it comes to capturing anything that isn't an extremely low rent in terms of system demands game, it has real problems. So, yeah. Perhaps someone could point out some better capture software for me. Although, I remember it taking me a million years to set this up due to audio syncing issues, so maybe not. Yeah, this is definitely one of those games you can just sit there and chip away at for hours, I think. Quite mindless. I imagine it gets a great deal more difficult. A lot of difficulty to be seen in this alpha, whatever it's called, E3 demo. Now that's cool, isn't it? You can use the slide as an attack. Ah, hello, buddy! Whoa, hang on now. Guy. Dick. Ah. What? Dead. Fucking a-holes. Ah, what I keep forgetting I've got. Do I have any other weapons? Question. So there you go, the Kung Fu shoes. The other thing, common cheap ring. Yeah, if you want to use kicks, then you can use the kung fu shoes. How delightful. Don't think there's a great variety of weaponry in this. Like I say, that's extremely early, and I think this is honestly just put out to stop the backers from having some sort of bias remorse or heart attack after Mighty Number 9. Oh shit. Oh, one thing I don't like about it is the boss design, which we'll see in a minute, but that's more a taste thing than anything else. It goes a bit mental in the anime direction. Or serial killer. Female serial killer, monsters with breasts. Same premise. Again, you can die. I do appreciate, again, the leveling up mechanics in this game. If someone like me who's not very good at platformers, or 2D side-scrollers, it's good that I can then just go back and grind a little bit. Sort of cheese my way through the boss battles. Can I just kill him before he swings? Yes. Oh, I did. Did I hit the cannon? Shit. No. You live and don't learn. That's the question go. Somewhere around here is a map. There it is. Come on, get to the upper deck. Oh, no, wait, no. This is backwards, isn't it? This is utterly backwards. Up there, then. Oh, great. Ooh. You die. Oh, damn it. Back. There you go. Eat that. Eat lots of that. Where the fuck am I going? Ah. Okay. Delta. think that'll be boss battle time very soon. And that fire shit does damage. This one new? Yes. Right. Not quite as leveled as I was last time I took on the boss, but I imagine we should be able to beat it. So yeah, here's the design that I think is just... what the fuck? I don't know. It's... I don't know what that is. How do you flames? Oh, bastard. Also, I just go back in my inventory and cheese the living shit out of this. Which I will do, quite shamelessly. God, the performance really taking a hit now. Again, playing the capture software. If this takes an overclocked i5 with a GTX 980 to run, then it's got real fucking problems, but it doesn't. Nope. Might as well use the rest of my ether. So it was. Right, die. Please die. Sweet Jesus, die. And I've leveled up, which I think means the enemy is dead. Yep. Thanks for playing. Thank you for playing indeed. Well, I guess that's that. All 12 minutes of it. And according to OBS, percentage of dropped frames, zero. A clear lie. Anyway, that's Bridge of the Night. I think it's alright. Pretty promising. Well, it bodes well for the future. I don't know when the actual release date for this is supposed to be, but judging by the millions they made from it, I think it's safe to say it's going to be alright. So yeah. If you want to play this, I don't know that you can through legal means. Maybe a friend will let you play it on their Steam account, or maybe you'll steal it. So, there you go.